students, welcome to this chemistry practical class. Dear students, as in my previous video I have told you about the volumetric analysis practical. Today I am going to perform that practical in front of you. So the first step that in any kind of practical that we are performing is we should know the experiment. So if I tell you about the experiment name, it is written there: to prepare a standard solution of M/50 ferrous ammonium sulfate using this solution, determine molecularity of the given KMnO4 solution. Okay, so for that purpose, dear student, there are two solutions being used there. Number one is M/50 ferrous ammonium sulfate. So this is ferrous ammonium sulfate we have. Okay, so this is also called Mohr salt. So don't be confused if it is written as Mohr salt. So it is same. Second, with the help of this salt, we can determine the molarity of given KMnO4. So this is purple color solution, that is KMnO4, if you will see. Okay, so both the solution, volumetric analysis we will do with both the solution. We will do the titration of both the solution. So the first step that is there, that is about the apparatus. Okay, so one by one I am going to show you apparatus. The first apparatus is burette. So this set is called burette. This long tube like apparatus is called burette, which have here controlling knob. You can see, with the help of this, we can control the running of solution. So, okay, by switching off the knob, we can control the knob of switch. Second, if burette is fixed in the stand, then the name is called burette stand. Okay, with this, we should have measuring flask. We need wash bottle. We need, this is titrating flask. We can see this process is called titration. So we will continue titrating the solution with this so that it will constantly dissolve properly. Until it will not dissolve properly, the volumetric will not occur and the one solution will not make bond with other solution. Okay, so we need to keep on steering it like this way. This is called titration. Then we should have concentrated H2SO4, which is we need to handle with very carefully. We need beaker, 250 ml beaker, watch glass in which salt is carrying, then the glass door for dissolving the salt. Okay, so when we have all these things, now if you will see about the chemical, so ferrous sulfate ammonium sulfate crystal, KMnO4, potassium dichromate, potassium permanganate solution, dilute H2SO4 and concentrated H2SO4. We have all these four solutions here for chemical. Now the reaction is what? The basically to KMnO4 will react with H2SO4 with ferrous sulfate to give us potassium sulfate, manganese sulfate and ferrous sulfate of with 8 molecule of water. Okay, in term of ion electron equation, this reaction is a redox reaction and it will come under redox reaction. Indicator means which indicate the difference in color. Indicator is KMnO4 itself, self indicator. The end point is will be there, what pink color, violet color solution will be there, purple color solution, that will be changed into colorless. Okay, when the moment the purple color solution of KMnO4 will change into colorless, that point is our end point. Okay, so let's start the procedure. The procedure is what? First, to prepare the M/50 ferrous ammonium sulfate solution. So for that purpose, we need to weight first exactly 1.96 gram of Mohr. So that I have done, 1.96 gram of Mohr is there inside this watch glass. We have taken it in a clean and dry watch glass, in which we will transfer the salt into 250 ml of beaker. Okay, so I'm going to transfer it into the 250 ml of beaker. Okay, after that, wash the watch glass. We will wash the watch glass. This watch glass we need to wash with the wash bottle properly. Okay, then we will add the water in this watch glass, in this beaker, to dissolve. So here I kept some water for little boiling, because hot water will dissolve easily. So side by side I kept one this beaker also for washing. So now I am going to dissolve this. Once we dissolve it, now we need to make this solution. This is the solution of ferrous ammonium sulfate. After this, we will add 2 drops of, at the moment the solution will get dissolved properly, we will add 2-3 drops of H2SO4 in this Now, dear students, here one question is raised in your mind, I think. Why there is a need to put 2-3 drops of H2SO4 in the solution? Okay, so here I want to tell you, I added 2-3 drops of H2SO4 so that this solution will not get oxidized. Okay, it helps us to prevent the solution from oxidizing. Now, when the solution is ready, we need to put this solution in our titration flask. We will add some water until okay, after that we will shake it properly, we will mix this solution properly. After mixing the solution, you need to keep their space. And after this solution, we will keep this solution inside the beaker. And this solution will be marked as M upon 50 oxalic acid. Okay, this solution will be marked at M upon 50 ml oxalic acid. Now we are going to start the practical. So if we are going to start the practical, we should know some of the steps. Our first job is that we will going to wash our burette with the help of water. First we will rinse the burette with the help of water to ensure that it is clean or not. So as I am cleaning it with the help of water, so it is clean now. One time we clean it with water. Now second time we will rinse it with KMnO4. This is very important. We will rinse this solution with KMnO4, but before going to rinse it, fill it, you need to ensure that this knob should be closed and you cannot use too tight, you cannot keep it too loose. After that you will fill the burette stand by keeping one backup. You can see the color of your burette become purple. Okay. Once we will rinse and fill the burette, then now we will fix the anti-parallax card on the burette. This is anti-parallax card which we fixed on the burette. Okay, this is anti-parallax card which is fixed in the burette so that we will note down the upper meniscus of the label, because the color solution is colored, so we will check the upper meniscus. If solution is colorless, then we will use its lower meniscus. Okay. So now this is that KMnO4 which we have with that, but why we need, there is need to rinse first so that we will get the perfect reading. Okay, once you fill it, once we fill the solution up to, by looking the mark up to zero, we will start the reading from zero. Okay, this is my zero point, this is my zero point. Rest of the solution I will now, dear students, we have done what? We rinse and wash the burette with KMnO4. Then after that, we fix the anti-parallax card here just for reading purpose. Then we record the upper meniscus. Now we will pip it out 20 ml of more salt solution in the titration glass. For that purpose, we should have 20 ml of pipette. This is 20 ml pipette. You can see the shape. This is called 20 ml pipette. Okay. So we will rinse the 20 ml pipette. But before going to rinse the pipette, we will rinse it with water first. Just to learn how to rinse, we need to suck. Take the solution with the help of this. This is 20 ml pipette. So we will, there's one mark. Up to this mark, we will suck that solution. So before doing with the solution, we will do practice with the water. How to do the procedure, very simple, we need to suck it. जैसे आप कोक के स्ट्रॉ से सक करते हैं वैसे आप इसका करना. एंड सपोज दिस इज सी, अप टू दिस मार्क्स आई हैव टेकन सॉल्यूशन, सो अप टू दिस मार्क्स वी विल टेक. आफ्टर दैट इफ यू रिलीज द ओपनिंग द वाटर विल रन ऑटोमेटिकली बिकॉज ऑफ एयर प्रेशर. ओके, नाउ सेम थिंग वी विल डू इन दिस टाइट्रेशन, वी विल पुट that solution which we have prepared, that is more salt. Okay, so the same way I am sucking it, keep it down and we will start sucking. This is very, sometime it will take time because okay. Now there's 20 ml I have taken. You can see here 20 ml I have taken. This is the solution. This is the mark and solution I have taken up to this point. Okay. Now I will put that 20 ml more salt in this titration flask. Now the procedure is very simple. Practically is very simple. Practically is not difficult. Nothing we have to do. No, none. Not big rocket science we have to use. We will take that 20 ml solution in this, very simple. After that, we will start titrating. Now, this is practical. Okay, how to do the start titrating? Just have to focus here. While you are doing titration, first thing we will not do by sitting, but I am sitting just for so that it should be visible. For. The students, see here, this is titration flask and this is burette, in which burette have KMnO4. In titration flask, I took ferrous ammonium sulfate. Now, I want to mix the ferrous ammonium sulfate with the titration. The solution which is in burette, that is KMnO4. This solution color is right now a little bit yellow, or you can say colorless, but this should become the pink. So the indicator is itself KMnO4, which will change this solution pink. Okay, now there are few things that you need to take care. Number one, you need to run the solution of burette very slowly, constantly, like drop by drop. And the moment you are running the solution drop by drop like this way, just focus here, please pay attention by doing zoom. Suppose this is first drop is going like this way, little bit speed you will do, but your one hand should be here, one hand should be here. Then while drop is going to be mixed, constantly you need to steer it. This is steer, this is called titration. This process is called titration. Because of this process, the practical name is titration. Okay, volumetric analysis titration. So you will keep on titrating until this solution is not becoming pink. Okay, I'm running solution. You have to focus here. The solution should convert into pink color. The moment solution will change into pink, this will reach to the end point, and that is called the first reading. That point is our first reading. Okay, so please focus. Two, three things I told you. Number one, the solution you need to run very smoothly, constantly, gradually, it should not very much fast. Second thing, while solution is running in the titration flask, you should keep on titrating it, okay, until this will not reach to the that point where the solution is becoming totally pink. Okay, ab ye zarurat kyun hai hilane ki, because that in with the help of this, the solution is going to be react thoroughly with all type of solution. If I will keep it like this, so the solution is running one time and maybe we will reach end point and we are not observing that end point. Okay, so we are about to reach to the pink point. You can see the color change into slowly into pink. Okay, so we will reach, the moment we will reach, we will stop the running of solution. That is our end point. Okay, so So I will stop the solution and you can see the color of solution become now pink. Earlier it was like this, now it become like this. So there is a change in color. This is our end point. Now we started the reading from 0 and we reached up to 13. It is, we will reach the parallax here. Now here I just want to bring my camera, see here. It is the reading point. If I will take my camera up to this, you can see here there is 12 point, a small
small point is there, small lines are there. These lines are representing the reading, and it is somewhere 12.8. So my first reading is 12.8, and the parallax will fix like this way, and the solution will run from here, and solution will run from here, and it will come this type of curve. Okay, so that thing we will
this is our observation table, and first reading we started from 0.0 ml to we reached 12.8 ml. Okay, so it means that 12.8 minus 0, volume of KMnO4 used 12.8 ml. Like this way, now second reading we will start from 12.8 ml. Okay,
second time again we will do the same thing.
So now once again we will do the second reading. I'm going to take in the same way, I will pop it out 20 ml of ferrous ammonium sulfate in the titration flask. So let's start. Sometimes solution is going inside the mouth also, so you need to take care. Slowly, slowly, gradually you need to suck. You should not suck like a cold drink, because it is not cold drink. The solution can be harmful for your body. Okay, it is 20 ml. The moment we will take 20 ml ferrous ammonium sulfate inside the titration flask, rinse it properly. After that we will start our second reading. Second reading will start from 12.8, which you have seen. Now from 12.8 we are going to start again. You start the solution very slowly, thoroughly, and keep on titrating it until we will not get the pink color. Okay, it will not, the color of solution will not change into pink. You can constantly see here, your eye should be here and your hand should be here. It means that like this way you can control the solution. Okay, so the moment we will reach, we will stop the solution run. That is our second reading. You cannot, couple of things you will see, you cannot touch like this way, that is also negative point. You cannot too much, you cannot do like this way, okay. So then you stop the solution, then you are doing like this way. This is not the right way, okay. You will not do like this way. Only this is the procedure. You need to keep on running the solution, and you need to keep on seeing here the pink, when color solution of liquid is going to be changed into pink. First it is appearing yellow, then from yellow orange, orange to pink. The moment the color will become dark orange, you can be a little bit more proactive that the solution is about to reach to the end point. Okay, so we reached in the point of this is, you can see this is a little bit pink. So now we will again record our reading that we reached. So you can see here, so you can see here it is somewhere 24.6 is the reading, and the we will write here. Now we started from 12.8, the reading is now 24.6 ml. 24.6 minus, you can do 24.6 minus 12.8, 811, it is 11.8 ml. Okay, so these are the two reading. Like this way you will read one more reading you can take, that will start from 24.6, or let it be up to suppose 38.6. if I'll say the 38, it will come 14.0 ml. Okay, now what we will do, we will add these three. Suppose 8, 8, 16, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 48. So it means that 448 upon 0.6 upon 3, it will come somewhere 15.0
16 point. It will become 16.2, and 16.2 ml is the our mean value. After that we will use the calculation. In calculation, KMnO4 is more salt, versus more salt is there, so there is a all the values m upon 50, b1 is 10 ml, b2 is 20 ml. Okay, then we will find out the calculation. 5 multiply by m1 is what? Now we need to calculate molarity of KMnO4 is equal to 10. 1 into m upon 50 into 20. Here in place of 10 you will write 16.2 ml. When you are calculating 16.2 ml here, you will get some values. That value will be the result of molarity of KMnO4 solution. So hope so you got, my dear students. And you need to write this practical like the way student has written. Suppose this is the last year notebook and student has done this experiment like this way. All the reading, everything, then after reading calculation, after calculation they got the answer, and this is the practical, it is checked. Okay, so like this way you will do. So hope so you got now. And so this is all about for today's, my dear students. Hope so you got this practical, and now when you will come to school and you will perform this practical by your own, so before going to perform yourself, you can watch this video. Okay, so this is all about for today. I have tried my best, although this is not like perfect way. Perfect way is that when practical I will perform in front of you, but due to this situation now we don't have any other alternate source, so I tried my best to bring my lab to your home and to conduct my practical from my lab, and you can learn by watching this video and you note down this practical notebook. Okay, so thank you very much for your patience listening. Stay blessed, stay home, take care of yourself. Thank you.